Ladies and gents, we are here in Football Manager 2017. This is just the beta. It came out almost 2 weeks ago. The official release is on the 4th of this month, and which is just a couple of days away, but we've had some early access to it. And I have to say, overall, it's pretty much the exact same as 2016. They really did some good minor changes. The social media aspect is fun. Some of the graphical enhancements are nice to look at. The video is nice to look at, but overall it is pretty much the exact same as 2016. So with that, if you absolutely love Football Manager, get it. If you're brand new to the series, get it. If you are one of those that I used to be, which is to basically buy it every other year, and you bought 2016, wait till 2018. Just skip this one. It really, to me, doesn't add a whole lot to the game. With that said, this is still the best Football Manager game I have ever played. I played a couple, and this one just takes the cake. It beats everything else out there. So it is still fun. It is still absolutely one of the most annoying things I've ever played. And you'll see in the save that I've got right here. So my beta save, what I'm trying to do is I try and take one team throughout a season, get used to the game, get used to some of the quirks of the game, and see what the pluses and minuses are. And Roma is this year's save. It was my final save on 2016, but I figured I had a lot of fun with it, so let's bring it back for the beta of 2017. And here you can see on this screen, I ended up fifth. I don't know how I did it. I'll show you the league later on, but I was doing very well against teams like Napoli and things like that, but then drawing or losing some of the teams against like Crotone, Sassuolo, Torino, things like that, just games I should have just hands down won, and it made no sense to me. But what are you going to do? That's Football Manager for you. Transfers. You can see, basically, I started out with 10 million, and that was it during the summer of 16. It's a hard thing to do, to start out with 10 million, and to try and bring in some actual quality players to bring a club like Roma up to, you know, the top three. So with that, I had to get rid of a few players that I wasn't going to do anything with. Enzeko, I am not a big fan of. I never have been. So he was the first to go for 14.75 million to Everton. I have no idea how he's done. Let's take a look. He has league 24 plus 9. So 33 games, 6.78 rating, 7 goals, 4 assists, 1 player of the match. I'm happy I got rid of him. He's not one that was going to do anything with Roma. I've never been a big fan of the front man. Diego Perotti. This is one that I struggled with. I really wanted to keep him there. He's got great potential. I mean, great potential. He's 29 years old. 28 years old, sorry. He is definitely one that I wanted to keep around. But in the end, I needed to bring some people in. And he was going for a lot of money. Iturbe was another one that was going to go for some money, not quite as much. But in the end, I figured Iturbe was younger. He had more potential ability. I just had to keep him around, so Perotti got the axe. League appearances, you can see 24 and 8, 6.77 rating, 3 goals, 2 assists. So he really wasn't used as best as he could by Tottenham. But hey, that's Tottenham's problem, not mine. Noura Abdullahi came in at the end of the season. He'd been injured for so long that. He doesn't have the potential I wanted, his loan just went away. The players I brought in, Luan and Angel Correa, were the two that I brought in this summer. I've got to say, especially now that I know the game, not the greatest of signings in terms of, look at the fees that they came in for. Luan was 13.25 million, Angel Correa 17.5 million. You'll see Luan is at 105,000 per week. That is just insane for a 24-year-old, in my opinion, of course. Today's, you know, football God, players are just going for a lot more. But you'll see, 33 appearances, 14 goals, 6 assists, player of the match one, 7.02 rating. He's been very good, I have to say. International, he got his start with us, but I'm not going to take credit for that, but whatever. So I the stats say that he's done very well. I have to say, playing with him, I played mostly as him with him as a striker. Toddy is on the older side. I know he's an absolute Roma favorite, and luckily he's retiring at the end of the season. But so I had Luan basically in the striker position. I'd move him out to the left winger from time to time. The stats say one thing. Watching his gameplay was a bit of a pain, I have to say, because he didn't do what I had hoped. He didn't create all the chances that I had hoped. There were a lot of, missed opportunities that you would see in the gameplay. But, the stats do say that he was our top goal scorer, with, what is it, 18 in all competitions. So, still very good. Angel Correa was another one. The stats say one thing, 7.10 average rating, 30 appearances, 4 goals, 8 assists. He was our top assist man. But again, watching him play didn't do a whole lot for my confidence in him. You'll see all his technical abilities, mental, physical, they're all going down for some reason. I don't know why. But whatever. 67,000 per week for a 22-year-old is still a little higher than I'd like, but that transfer fee is just the killer. So now we have the others. Antonio Hornero. So the biggest thing I found in this beta is injuries are insane. I had two to start off with, but they just kept piling up and piling up and piling up until I found myself with no players that I could, I couldn't even fill a bench. It was crazy how many injuries that I had. So what I ended up having to do is I brought Antonio Hornero in as a free, and he was going to be my midfielder of not of choice, but basically a backup that I could use when everyone else was too tired, because we had fixtures, we had league, we had the cup, and we had Champions League, and it was just going insane. So he came in as a free. Martin Zubimendi, he was supposed to come in during the summer. However, I was stupid enough and did not realize that his personal term said he wasn't coming in till January. Ah, well. Antonio Hornero, let's look at his stats. He started 5. He came in off the bench at 12. He did have one goal. 6.81 rating, not exceptional, but however, for a free who has very little potential, I mean, you'll see 1.5 stars to 2.5 stars, not very good of what you would expect. However, 6.81 is respectable. I've got to give him that. He's definitely one that I'll keep in mind for other saves. Maybe not the top clubs, but definitely someone who can come in off the bench and put in a fairly solid performance. Zubimendi, I didn't use him. I used him once. He came in so late he didn't even get an average rating. So, but another one that, I try and get the best potential rating, and out of all the frees that I had, there weren't any. 2.5 stars was the absolute most. So Maximiliano Romero, I brought in for 3.7 million. However, the problem I had with him, and it's one of the things that I was unfamiliar with in the Italian market, is that he's from Argentina, so he's considered a I guess non-homegrown player, and you can only have a certain amount of non-homegrown players in your team, or at least registered with your team. So I could not find anyone who I could get rid of and bring him in. But I mean, look at his potential. It's 4 stars, possibly 5. He's at a 2.5 star ability. So, and I couldn't get rid of, certain players. You'll see, oh, these are all gone, but these non-EU players, I couldn't get rid of a lot of, I couldn't get rid, I couldn't sell the ones that I wanted to. I even tried Iturbe and nobody wanted him for some reason. I mean, a 7.02 average rating, 16, 26 starts, 5 goals, 3 assists. Come on. I mean, no one wanted him, even at like 6 million, which was his rating at the time. He's what? He's 4.9 now. So I just couldn't get rid of players. And so Maximiliano Romero, I just could not bring in, and I'm very sad. However, he is one that I'm going to keep in mind for the future. For future saves, I mean, just look at that. At how old is he? He's 18, and he's already at, El Shaarawy's level, or just a little before. But, that's how it is. So let's get on to these stats. So top goal scorer, Luan with 18. You can see Kostas Manolas had the higher average rating with 7.49. He was absolutely magnificent this season. Another one that I'll keep in mind for future saves. Angel Correa, 16 assists. Damn, I mean, that guy could assist like crazy. Alessandro Florenzi with 7 Player of the Match awards. He is one that I use mostly as a right back. He's most proficient as a right winger. I did use him every now and again as a right winger. But I mean, 7.31 average rating, 33 appearances, 2 goals, 11 assists in the league alone. This guy is fantastic. And what I like to play with in terms of the fullbacks is I need one left back, one right back, and another player that can play both. And they will always be on the bench or playing as long as they're not injured, of course. And so in my squad, I had Emerson Palmieri, Bruno Perez was my both, which he started a lot of games, I have to say. But then I had, then I had Florenzi on the right. So they did a lot of rotation. You'll see Bruno Perez. What that's what 30 43 games. I mean, these guys were playing like monsters. Manolas with 46 games, Florenzi with 47 games. These guys were just going like gangbusters. Daniel De Rossi, most yellow cards, 15 yellow cards throughout the season. I like the guy. He played well. He did an excellent job as a defensive midfielder for us. However, if he wasn't a Roma favorite, which I believe he is, he definitely would have been sold. The guy would pick up a yellow card every other match, pretty much. I mean, it was insane the amount of yellow cards this guy got. Not only that, however, after 60 minutes, he was done. He has the worst stamina I've ever seen. He is literally one of the first guys that I would sub off because his stamina was dead. He would get into the 60s. I mean, he'd start at 95 to 99 stamina and go straight down to 65 within 60 minutes, and it's just crazy. But again, fantastic player. He would probably do terrific off the bench if he wasn't what 33 years old. Alisson and Chesney, I had start because I know in real life he's a better goalkeeper. Alisson bitched and moaned saying he wasn't getting enough game time and he wanted to be transfer listed, blah blah blah. He went public with his want to be transfer listed, so I ended up giving him some game time. 7.04 average rating, pretty good. Bruno Perez, an absolute stalwart in my defense, loved him. Who else? Vermaelen, whatever you want to. Vermaelen and Manolas were my two main centers. Juan Jesus came in a lot. He started a lot, as you can see, 29 and 9. He did fill in for my left back every now and again. Rudiger got a lot of yellows. Another one with a yellow problem. He has he's just got an issue with getting yellow cards. Paredes was one that I loved in Football Manager 2016. I had to keep him around. I wanted to see how he was this year. I actually got him in my Liverpool save last year, and he just banged him in from, Gerrard distance left and right. He was absolutely insane. But this year he was more on the average side. Still did well, but Raja Nainggolan. Now this is a man who was injured for the first half of the season, and the first game, within the first couple of minutes he came in, he just banged him in. I mean, he was insane. This guy is one to keep in mind for future, for your future saves. Gerson, another one, future saver. Potential like crazy. He did fairly well when called upon. Not the greatest. I mean, he's still young. He's 20 years old. He's got, I mean, you'll see 4 to 5 star rating. He was probably 1.5 to 2 stars when he came in. But he was terrific. He was very good. Salah just banging him in left and right. Absolutely another one that you want to keep in mind. Sharawe, injury prone like mad. You'll see he's only a 6.73 average rating, but he just kept getting injured and injured and injured. He'd play very well when he was on the pitch, but just kept getting injured and I was getting tired of it. Toddy, he's in his final year of the contract. You had to give him some game time. Not my first choice striker. If the injuries didn't persist, I would have kept him off, but that's what you can do. Here you'll see the stats or the competitions. You'll see we cruise through, minus a Liverpool, funny enough, friendly. We cruise through the preseason with no problems. Champions League, you'll see we crushed Anderlecht 5-0 to get into the group stage. Then Benfica, we would win. Shakhtar, we would tie. And Madrid, we won and lost one. Or no, sorry, we lost this one and we tied here 1-1. And it got us into the group stage. Or it got us out of the group stage where we faced Barcelona. Funny enough, though, we won 2-1 at home. We lost 2-3 at Camp Nou. However, away goal rulings, we won. We came out and faced Bayern. Here's one. I changed up the tactics. We won the first one away, so it gave us a good away goal, which I was absolutely shocked at. And then the second one. Where's the second one? There we go. 2-1, we won at home. I mean, it absolutely amazed that we beat Barcelona, we beat Bayern, and then we faced Real Madrid. We lose 0-2 at home, sadly enough, and then we go to Madrid and we beat them 1-0, but not enough to get them in. You'll see it was basically Tottenham over Lyon. And in the end, final, you'll see that Tottenham actually crushed Madrid in extra time, 5-2. So whatever, sucks to be Ronaldo. But so when you get to the league, you'll see games like this: Napoli 4-0. I mean, that was a great game. But then Torino we tied. Milan, I'll give you that 0-1 away loss. That's fine. Fiorentina 2-3. Lazio, they were top two, top three all year. Inter was as well. So I'll give you those. But 3-0 at Empoli, Cagliari, Chievo, Atalanta, Sampdoria. I mean, we went on a pretty good run. But then came March, and you'll see right around here, Genoa 0-1, Lazio 0-1. We did have a 3-0 crushing of Inter, but I mean, things that just you'd have a win and then you'd have a couple losses or a tie, and it beat your players. It just didn't work very well. So in the end, we came off as fifth place. We kind of picked it up in the end, which is great, but fifth place does not get us Champions League. It only throws us into Europa group stage. So, but that's that. The good news is, if I ever decided to keep going with this, the board, it's finances. They did give us. This is actually a save a little less. A save a little before. I had simmed it to July, and we actually get 60 million in a transfer budget. So overall, the season was okay, not exceptional. I am definitely going to try a new team for the official save when it comes out on the 4th. The review that I have is, again, If you're going every other year and you've purchased 2016, skip this one. It's really not that much different. I really want them to change a lot of things in 2018. What can I do? I'm on 59 grand a week. What the hell does that mean? Absolutely nothing. You can't buy a house. You can't, claim stake in a team when you retire. You can't do anything. So you might as well just put your transfer, your weekly wages as, £1 and then save that for your transfer budget. Absolutely pointless. I mean, there's a lot of things that should change, but great game overall. The three biggest issues I have with this are injuries, injuries, injuries. Absolutely way too many injuries. Pointless, to be honest. You're playing with this huge squad and they all get injured and you're down to you could barely fill a bench. The other issue I had, penalties. I had in the last five or six games, six or seven penalties, all of which minus one or two I missed. I don't know how you do that. I've never seen a team do that. And it doesn't seem realistic. The other one, the first half of the season, I had a huge issue where a player would get into the middle with the ball, shoot, and it would come off his own player. Not himself, but another, someone on his team. And it happened over and over again, at least two or three times a game, where you'd have a shot, it looked like it was going in, or at least on target, and it would bounce off another player on your team. And that made no sense. I hadn't seen that in the second half of the game, or the second half of the season, when they did patch the game. Maybe they fixed it. Maybe it was just something in my game. I don't know. But those are the three big issues that I had. I'm still going to be happy starting a new save. I'm definitely going to be doing a Liverpool save. I may be doing a Barcelona save at some point just to see what issues I can come up with. We'll see. I may do some other things, German clubs and lower leagues, but we'll see how it goes. Anyway, that is Football Manager 2017 for me. My Roma save is done, and that is all. Enjoy!